Hi, I'm Marc Spehalski, Senior VoIP Engineer at VoIP Supply. Today, we're going to take a look at the AudioCodes MP112 FXS Gateway, and we're going to be doing a basic configuration of using an analog phone and communicating with a RenegadePBX. First, let's take a look at what's in the back. We have our power port, Ethernet port, two FXS ports for analog devices, and a reset button for setting to factory defaults. Next, we'll plug in the MP112 FXS Gateway to the power in our network so we can get started. Also plug in the analog device you're going to use. I'm using this analog telephone.
Our objective with the AudioCodes MP112 FXS Gateway is to simply plug in an analog phone into one of the FXS ports and have it communicate with an extension on our RenegadePBX. To start, we'll log in with the default credentials, which are admin for the username and admin for the password, both using a capital A. I've already changed the IP address to one that will work on my network. By default, it will be 10.1.10.10. This can be changed by going to VoIP, Network, IP Interfaces Table, entering it under IP address. For the next step, click Coders and Profiles, Coders. For this example, we use G711A with packetization time 20, rate 64. Click Submit. Next, go to SIP Definitions, click Proxy and Registration. We want to click Yes for Use Default Proxy, click the arrow for Proxy Set Table, enter in your PBX information. We'll be using UDP for this example. Click Submit. Make sure Always Use Proxy is enabled, as well as Enable Registration. We'll enter some information for our PBX. Make sure subscription mode is per endpoint and registration mode is also by per endpoint. Click Submit. Now click on Gateway in IP to IP. Click on Hunk Group and Endpoint Phone Number. We'll use Channel 1 and Extension 2003, which is already programmed in our RenegadePBX. Click Submit. Next, go to Analog Gateway and Authentication. We will use FXS Port 1, Extension 2003, and I'll enter the predefined password. Last, we'll click Routing, Telephone to IP Routing. Enter the IP address of your PBX. Our RenegadePBX is 10.10.10.73. Use port 5060 for SIP. Set transport type to UDP. Click Submit. If your AudioCodes gateway has not yet registered to the PBX, you can click on Endpoint Phone Number and click the button that says Register. You could then check the status by clicking on Status and Diagnostics, Registration Status. We can see that FXS Port 1 is now registered to the PBX. To make sure everything's working, we'll place a test call from our IP phone to our analog, and then from our analog to our IP phone. So first, IP to analog. I'll dial 2003. Now from the analog, I'll dial 2002. It looks like they both work. Finally, our last step to make sure everything is saved, click on the burn button in the gateway. And that's all there is to it.
So we've set up our AudioCodes MP112 FXS Gateway to use an analog phone with our RenegadePBX. For any other questions regarding the MP112, you can call us at 800-398-VoIP or go to VoIPSupply.com. Once again, my name is Marc Spehalski, Senior VoIP Engineer at VoIP Supply. Thanks for watching.